Hi everyone and welcome back. And here we are going to start our GraphQL series. And first we are going to talk about the Yoga, a GraphQL library to create a GraphQL APIs. Okay, so we are going to start with very basics, then intermediate, then advanced, and we will talk about GraphQL with the Prisma, GraphQL with the SQLize, TypeORM, GraphQL with the pagination, authentication, authorization, and the testing the GraphQL APIs, right? So all these things we are going to cover in the whole series. So first we are going to start with the very beginner, okay? And we will start this with the setting up with our basic project, right? And what we are going to use, GraphQL Yoga as a library. You can also use Apollo GraphQL. And we are going to use ES6 Node.js, like we are going to use the import syntax. So we need Babel. So what we did is in the package.json, we just added these two dev dependencies, Babel CLI and Babel preset env. That's it, and the GraphQL Yoga. These three libraries, nothing else. And how to create a basic GraphQL server with the Yoga library. I'm not going to cover very basic, like what is GraphQL and all these things. I have already covered a lot of playlists talking about GraphQL, REST, what is good, when should we use what. There is nothing bad and nothing good. It's just about the use case. On some places, the REST is always better. On some particular use case, the GraphQL is better. Okay, so here, if you just see, I just have an index.js file in the whole project. And what this index.js file is talking about? Simple, bare-bone GraphQL server. So what I did is I imported GraphQL Yoga. I got the GraphQL server. And I'm feeding only two things in the GraphQL server. One is a type definition and another is a resolver. So whenever we talk about GraphQL, we are going to talk about these two terms a lot. GraphQL server, type definitions, resolvers, query, mutation, subscription, and simple GraphQL server, right? So if you see, the type definitions are nothing but you can relate it with the TypeScript types, right? Where we are defining the types, enums, interface, classes, and all. But little bit different here. These schema means we are creating the types which you are going to expose through the query and mutation. These are the resolvers. Resolver is an object where you will define the actual implementation for your query and mutation. When I say, so GraphQL can be divided into three things. Query API is where you are requesting a data. Mutation API is where you are updating the state of a data. Subscription API is where you are listening to a change happening to a particular data set, right? So these three things GraphQL exposes. In this hello world example, I'm just exposing a simple query. Here you can write mutation, subscription, the type definitions, and the actual implementation will be defined inside a resolvers. That's it. Now you just pass both the objects into the GraphQL server and it will start. The same implementation you can do with the GraphQL Express server or using Apollo GraphQL server. Here we are using GraphQL Yoga. There are many libraries are available right now which does the same thing, that will help you to create your GraphQL server. Directly or indirectly, they will ask you, okay, what is your type definition? What are the resolvers you wanted to expose? And what we do is we can just do npm run start. Based on package.json definition, npm run start, and it should be able to start our server on a defined port. Okay, once this server is started, we can do a lot of things. Here, currently, this is doing nothing. It is having one simple plain query, which is hello. So this query will be exposed when you try to see this GraphQL like REST. In the REST, we look for the Swagger APIs. Okay, what is a get, put, post, delete API? Similarly, in the GraphQL, it also provides you the GraphQL browser console. Okay, we can use different add-ons which are available on the browser. So you just pass this and you can access all the query and mutations available. We have only hello query here. Okay, stay tuned. So this is a very basic setup. You can actually copy this from the GitHub. Simple three libraries. GraphQL Yoga is a library to create a GraphQL server. I'm using this Babel CLI and Babel R. This file is required because this is what will tell GraphQL to define the presets. Okay, how to compile, what to compile. Okay, So let's see, in the next video we'll expose it on the browser using some add-on. We will see what kind of documentation we are getting, same as Swagger. So GraphQL is nothing but an API interface, little bit different than the rest, because in the rest you have a different HTTP verbs, get, put, post, delete. Here we will talk only about post, and we will be send a query and mutation and subscription through that post API to our GraphQL server, and we will receive the data in the same way we were receiving in the REST APIs. Okay, let's talk that in the next video.